Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear respected brothers and sisters in the city of Ottawa Gatineau and all around the world and in Canada especially, welcome back to our special program during the coronavirus flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance, we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala assistance, we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to deliver us out during that difficult time, stronger in faith, closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, more reliant on Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. The Ottawa Muslim Association is still functioning, doing an amazing job in serving the community here in the city of Ottawa and Gatineau. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, our volunteers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them, sisters and brothers who dedicated their times to serve the community, to give out the food bags that we prepared, to give out the hygiene bags that we are giving. And also, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we have a good partnership with the brothers and sisters in the Sadaqa Food Bank. So inshallah, bi-idhnillah, they will be using our facilities here in Ottawa Muslim Association in cooperation to help our Muslim community and our human Canadian community at large. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all those who are working behind the scenes, all those brothers and sisters who are making this live stream possible. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Coming back to our program, flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will just remind me and you that inshallah, after finishing our program today, at 6 o'clock inshallah, bi-idhnillah, there is a national prayer done by all Canadian Imams and Canadian Muslims, and this will be live streamed inshallah bi-idhnillah at canadamuslims.ca. If you go to that website after we finish inshallah at 6 o'clock, you can watch live streaming national prayers from Imams of Muslims in the Canadian community, making prayers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps all Canadians in this time of coronavirus. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Coming back to what we started yesterday in the levels of preparations for our month of Ramadan, we started with tawbah and istighfar and good intention and firm determination, and also knowing the value of time of the month of Ramadan. And then we stopped at the station of dua. And we said yesterday, or we mentioned yesterday, about 29 tips. How can we get our dua accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Today, brothers and sisters, we will mention when our dua is accepted. When our dua is accepted. What are the times that we focus in so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can accept our dua? And we will take this from the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first time is in the last part of the night. The last part of the night, you can divide the night since the coming of Maghrib until Fajr. And you can divide it into three parts. And the last third part of night, this is the time when the dua is being accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Muslims among the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim who have done this, and all Muslims who will do this until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, when he subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Sajdah, تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Those believers will leave and forsake their beds during the time of night, the last hour of the night, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon fear and hope. They live in between fear and hope, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their dua. So the first time is the last part of the night. As Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the authentic narration, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down in a matter that befits Him each and every night by the last part of the night. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala calls, is there anyone asking me something and I will give? Is there anyone asking forgiveness? I will forgive. Is there anyone coming back to me in tawbah? I will accept the tawbah until the fajr comes up. So, jawful layl al-akhir, or the last part of the night, is the first time that we should focus on. Number two, brothers and sisters, when the adhan is called for each and every salah, this is a good time when we can make dua. Sayyidina Abu Umama radiallahu anhu, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when the caller calls the adhan, or the muadhin calls the adhan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the doors of heavens to be opened and the dua will be accepted. The hadith in Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari, when the caller, the muadhin calls, Allahu Akbar, until he says, La ilaha illallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the doors of the heaven that we can make dua and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from us. And also, Sayyidina Sahl ibn Sa'd radiallahu anhu narrates a hadith, it is also in al-Bukhari, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 2 hours that the doors of heavens will be opened at, and a few people will be calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these 2 hours, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the dua during these 2 hours when the adhan is called, and also when the jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is called. So these are two times, one of which is adhan time. And somebody will say, we should say it with the muadhin or after the muadhin. After the muadhin, he finishes, we send salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he commanded us, and we ask him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the Prophet, the wasilah, the position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give to the Prophet on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, so we can receive shafa'at al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the last part of the night, and then when the muadhin is calling the adhan, after he finishes, we say our adhkar and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And between adhan and iqamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has assigned that time also for acceptance of dua. When the adhan is done, before the iqamah is established, if you are especially in the masjid or outside, but you are having wudu and you can make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our dua. And also, if we go and see after wudu, when we make wudu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even accepts our dua before we come to salah. And the hadith is authentic when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, if you finish your wudu the way it should be, in a good way, and then you see, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, Allahumma ij'alni min at-tawwabin waj'alni min al-mutatahhirin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the 8 gates of Jannah for you. Whatever dua you make, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. So this is after doing wudu before going to the salah. And then after that, ad-dua of salah, inside salah, after we say Allahu Akbar and we start the salah, there is a dua to open the salah before even we read al-Fatiha. It's called dua al-istiftah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making that dua, and Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu asked him, oh Messenger of Allah, I sacrifice myself, my father and mother for you. You start salah and you wait a little bit before you read al-Fatiha, but you say something, what is it? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them that this is dua al-istiftah, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, Allahumma ba'id bayni wa bayna khatayaya kama ba'adta bayna al-mashriq wal-maghrib. O Allah, make it far between me and my sins as it is the distance between the mashriq, the east and the west. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starts reading al-Fatiha after that. So another time after we just say Allahu Akbar in the salah. One more time when we read al-Fatiha and when we say Ameen. Saying Ameen with the Imam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, the angels will be around us when we pray salah. And if our Ameen comes with the Ameen of the Malaika, the angels, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us all our previous sins. Because Fatiha in itself is a dua. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, maliki yawmiddin. Praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we ask him in dua, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. This is a dua. And then we say Ameen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our dua if we do so. And then when we come up from ruku' in salah, when we say سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ حَمْدًا طَيِّبًا طَاهِرًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ مِلْءَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمِلْءَ الْأَرْضِ وَمِلْءَ مَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَمِلْءَ مَا شِئْتَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ بَعْدٍ. Also, if you ask Allah anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. Going down in sujood, after we say سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْأَعْلَى 3 times, if we make dua in our sujood, as our beloved Prophet told us, the closest time between the servant and his or her Lord is the time in sujood. So call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your sujood, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from you. Another time, right before we say assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, we finish the tashahud and then we make du'as before we say assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the tribulations of dunya and the akhirah, from poverty and from the shaitan, before he salams out sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So let's do it. And then after finishing the salah, also this is a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our dua, as it is authentic narration that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Mu'adh ibn Jabal one day, and he said, Mu'adh, I love you so much, I will tell you something. Don't leave after each and every salah saying, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. O Allah, help me to remember you and to be thankful for you and to be doing ibadah in the best way. After salah, the dua is accepted. Sayyidina al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah radiyallahu anhu, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he finishes the salah, he will make the dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt, wa la mu'tiya lima mana'at, wa la yanfa'u dhal jadd minka al-jadd. So this small dua, Sayyidina al-Mughira said, the Prophet, once he salams out, he says that dua, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, tawheed, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, giving him subhanahu wa ta'ala everything. Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt wa la mu'tiya lima mana'at. Nothing will come except with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa la yanfa'u dhal jadd minka al-jadd. Nothing will benefit us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers, these are the times that our dua will be immediately accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, if we go and see the dua in salah, as we said istiftah, and then we said when we say ameen, and we said ruku' after ruku', and then in sujood, and then before we salam out and after salam, all these are times when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our dua. Another time is when it is raining. When the rain comes down, this is a specific time that our beloved messenger Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith that Sayyidina Sahl ibn Sa'd narrates, that in 2 times dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not turn the dua away. Allah will accept the dua in 2 times. And he said, whenever the adhan is called and whenever it is raining. When it is raining, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give you, like, He subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you want. He doesn't turn you away when you call upon Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He will always say, Allahumma sayban nafi'a. We ask you, Allah, that this rain will be beneficial for us. And also du'as on the day of Yawm al-Jum'ah, today is Friday. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, there is an hour of ijabah, of answering. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers our du'a during the day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. Most of the scholars said it is from Asr to Maghrib. So this is a time for us today that we make dua before Maghrib. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our dua. Another time, when we drink Zamzam water. It is narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, the water of Zamzam is for which reason it is drunk for. So we drink it and say, Oh Allah, give me shifa. Oh Allah, give me knowledge. Oh Allah, help me in this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that time accepts your dua. And also dua in the last 10 days of Ramadan. Ramadan is coming. The last 10 days of Ramadan, they have special preference. They have Laylatul Qadr, especially the old nights. In the last 10 nights, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua during that time. Whoever prays in Qiyam during these nights, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the dua. Also, brothers and sisters, the dua in the first 10 days of the month of Dhul Hijjah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua and the good amal during these days. And if we sleep during our sleep and we have wudu before we sleep and we wake up during the night time and we make dua, say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything, He subhanahu wa ta'ala will get it for us. And if we make wudu and pray, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our salah. And also, brothers and sisters, we have to focus on these times, or in these times. These are times for the dua to be accepted. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to these blessed times, that dua will be accepted inshaAllah, especially these days. Focus, we can do all of these things. We can do in the last hour of the night. We can do it after adhan. We can do it in salah. We can do it during the raining. It is raining nowadays in Canada a lot, subhanAllah. So once it is raining, just raise your hand and say the dua and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept every day of Yawmul Jum'ah, and also the last 10 days of Ramadan. Ramadan is coming. So prepare for Ramadan. Get ready for Ramadan to know when our dua is accepted and how can it be accepted. So inshaAllah, bithinillah, wait for us for another episode where our dua can be accepted. The places in which the dua will be mostly accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will know this tomorrow inshaAllah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to accept our a'mal. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Don't forget us in your dua, and don't forget to use the link in the video inshaAllah to donate for our masjid, to help us, to help the community. Wa jazakumullahu khayra. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.